everyone. My name is Ali Angiello, and I'm a master explainer here at the Ever Children's Adventure Garden at the New York Botanical Gardens.
Hi, my name is Fariha Ahmed, and I'm a senior explainer right here at the Children's Garden.
This month, we want to spotlight Janaki Ammal.
Janaki Ammal was an extraordinary woman from Kerala, India. Born in 1897, she was the first female botanist in India and the first Indian woman to earn a PhD in botany in the United States, University of Michigan in 1931. She was born during a time when women were not allowed to receive higher education, but Janaki still pursued her goals to study botany at one of the highest levels.
Yeah, it's amazing that despite all the obstacles put against her, she still achieved her dreams. So what inspired her to start studying botany in the first place?
Well, Ammal grew up inspired by her father. He had libraries full of books about botany. When she was older, she eventually pursued a career in botany, which was rare for women in India at the time and in the present as well.
I love how she followed her dreams that she had even from such a young age. Sadly, it was very common for women to be treated unfairly by men at the time. This was the case for Ammal during her studies as well. Her male teachers and classmates always underestimated her abilities and didn't believe she would even graduate.
Yet, despite her struggles, she still graduated, never succumbing to the discrimination she faced because of her gender and caste, which is an Indian social system based on levels.
And when she returned to her homeland, she continued to expand her legacy by conducting research to produce a sweeter sugarcane. And we still use this variation today.
Ooh, I'm so glad we have sweet sugar.
Right? I'm so thankful for her. But she made this type of sugar not just for our taste buds to enjoy, but to also help support the Indian economy and the environment.
With this new type of sugar, Janaki was able to prevent deforestation in India while also increasing food production.
And speaking of deforestation, Janaki cared a lot about the Silent Valley, a forest full of beautiful native plants in India. And after creating this efficient sugarcane variation, which allowed India to produce its own sugar instead of importing it from other countries, Janaki became an inspiring Indian figure. And she used this prominence to advocate for the protection of this forest. So think for a moment about Janaki's love for native plants. How can you and your family help protect plants in your own community?
Well, you can do a bunch of things. For example, you can help remove invasive plants or weeds that get in the way of native plants, like milkweed and the black-eyed Susan, which are native to New York.
Yeah, our native plants are not only beautiful, but they also help support healthy ecosystems. These plants help pollinators like bees, birds, and even bats thrive. And one fun and easy way to support native plants in your neighborhood is to plant their seeds by making native seed plant balls. And if you visit the Children's Garden this spring, we will be sharing this activity with our visitors for an activity related to plant champions.
Janaki's legacy continues at the Silent Valley National Park, which is located in India, and also through her own magnolia flower, the Magnolia cavus Janaki Ammal.
When you visit the Botanical Garden, don't forget to check out our beautiful magnolia collection. Spring is the perfect time to enjoy the beautiful pastels of the flowers while keeping the amazing Janaki Ammal in mind.